Hello everyone, welcome to the next session of SAP GRC Access Control. In this session, we will be discussing about Access Request Management. We already seen what is the use of Access Request Management. I would like to mention some statistics here in this session. Most of the GRC implementations, what I have seen, generally people tend to implement SOD. To overcome this emergency user management, people does use emergency access management. But the access request management and business role management is used lesser than if you compare it to SOD and emergency access management. So through this demonstration, I would like to request all the consultants, please do use access request management. This solves quite a lot of problem for long term running of any SAP system, as well as this is very easy to configure. Let's say if you do not want to have a complex access request management implementation, you can implement it in a very simple way to use this access request management, because the provisioning, the entire provisioning of our SAP system works with access request management. Also, you can pretty much automate everything in access request management. Yeah. So let's begin. In this session, we will be discussing about provisioning configuration. First one is maintain provisioning setting. The provisioning setting, we can configure provisioning settings. We will see detail one by one. First one is provisioning type. Here we have role provisioning type. There we have two options, direct provisioning and indirect provisioning. Direct provisioning means, as usual, using SU01, you create a user and assign the roles to the user. This we mention it as direct provisioning. Indirect provisioning means using HR. You already know that using HR Org Management, you can do provisioning in SAP system. So SAP GRC provides you the functionality. You can do provisioning based on your SAP HR, and you can also do combined provisioning. Let's say you wanted to provision some of this request with SU01 and some of the request with the SAP HR, that will also still possible. The second one is provisioning options, where we are talking about auto provisioning options. In auto provisioning options, we have a couple of options. Is auto provisioning at the end of request. That means, let's say you have a process in your workflow process, you need to have different steps of approval. So once all the steps of approval is done, then the provisioning will be done. Meaning, let's say you have a request which have four roles. So each four roles have four different role owners. So in that case, all the roles needs to be approved by the role owner, as well as some of the other approver, whatever we have configured in the system, needs to approve. So once all the approval steps are done, then the entire user will be provisioned at once at the end of the request. Second one is provisioning at the end of each path. Let's assume you have detours in this request. Some of the portion of the request is going to a different path for approval process, or maybe let's assume it's an SOD approvers or whatever the case it may be. So in this case, so when each path is completed, the step is completed, then it will be provisioned. You don't need to wait for entire process needs to be completed to provision the user. The third option is no provisioning. That means there is no auto provisioning at all. Next one is manual provisioning with auto password generation. This one, what you will do is it will do the provisioning manually, but the password will be generated automatically and sent to the user. The last option is the manual provisioning. In manual provisioning, what happens is that you will do the entire provisioning manually. So the access request management is used only for approval as well as all the business process flow. It will not be used as a provisioning system in the backend system. Next one is creating user options. Here, create user if does not exist. Let's assume that you you are requesting something, but you are not requesting for a create user. For example, for change user action, you created a request for a change user action, but the user does not exist in the backend system. In that case, you can create the user automatically in the system. So if this is selected, then it will also create the user if the user does not exist. For role action, so let's say you are assigning a role, new role, or adding a role. You created a request saying that add a new role, but you end of the request you found that the user does not exist in the system. The system will create a user in the backend system automatically. Then the password expiry, this perhaps you may be doing it manually at the moment. So once a user is created initially, how many days the initial password should be valid? So that also we can configure it here. Email status, this is also quite important setting. Send password, here you will get two options, yes or no. Let's say if you select yes, then the GRC system will send the password through email. If let's say we configure this as no, then the GRC will send a link to the user so that user can get the password from that link. So in that case, you can also specify a time period the password should be visible for this user. So after that, then they have to reset the password again. Okay, let's check in our system. Let's go to our SAP system. Go to SPRO, SAP Reference IMG, navigate to Governance, Risk and Compliance, Access Control, User Provisioning. Here we can maintain the user provisioning setting. Okay, click on Global Provisioning. These are direct and indirect and combined ones. Here we have this auto provisioning options and create users and validity, the email status, expiry days, and role delimitation during provisioning. So you can also have a system-wide delimit for the roles, so how long you can keep this role valid. The next one what we want to talk about is global provisioning setting as well as system provisioning settings. So we have two, if you've seen in our SPRO, we had two selections in the left-hand side of the screen. One is system provisioning settings, another one is global provisioning settings. Let's assume you have more than one SAP systems connected to the GRC. In your scenario that you wanted to have this provisioning setting different for each system. In this case, you can have system specific settings configured for each system. If you need that all the system need to have the same settings, you can configure that in the global system. That means whatever you configure in the global provisioning configuration, it will be applicable to the all the system connected to the SAP GRC. So if you wanted to change something, wanted to have system specific setting, you can configure it in the system specific settings which needs to have a different settings. So if there is a global setting which applies to all the system, if there is a system specific setting available to specific system, then it will override the global setting. Let's see in our system. So we have global setting as well as maintain system specific setting. So in our case, we have only one target systems. That's the reason we don't have a system specific. We configured everything in the global settings. Go back, we have configured. It's all configuration what we have done. So in the system specific setting, if you have more than one system, then you can create a target. We already know what is the target connector. Select the target connector and start configuring what you need to. So you can configure it in this screen for each system. Don't want. The next configuration we would like to discuss about is End User Personalization Form, EUP. This we have seen in our previous session during MSMP configuration. This EUP, end user personalization, helps the user to predefine the values based on templates. Meaning, we can create a personalized form. Using the personalized form, we can create template-based request. This actually helps to improve accuracy of your access request. You wanted to have some specific field, wanted to make it mandatory. There are a lot of advantages using this UP as well as this template form, that this will increase the accuracy of the request, because we can have static fields within this template, as well as we can define some conditions, like some fields are mandatory, or some fields which is not required, we can say this field does not display this field. It's a very useful configuration. Let's see how does it works. This end user personalization form, this configuration is done in SPRO. This is the path in the SPRO. Go to SPRO IMG, governance, risk and compliance, access control, user provisioning, and maintain end user personalization. Then we can create any number of EUP, so that we can use these forms in different stages. We will see that how do we use this form in different stages, using MSMP stage, as well as we can use these templates for our template based access request. In this UEP field, you can see this description of each field. So all the fields available in which is possibly required in access request is already defined here. The description of the value of the field, for example, here account number is coming from this logon data field. Yeah, for example, account number. So for example, account number request reason or field name, first name, last name, etc. Next one is default value. These values are automatically populated in the fields of access request screen. Let's say we put a default value here, this specific value will be automatically filled in with these values whenever we create an access request using this particular UEP. Next column is mandatory. By choosing yes or no in the drop-down list under this mandatory field, any fields in the access request can be made mandatory. So let's say we wanted to have some of the field as a mandatory field when we are creating access request, then we can define it here. In this above screen, what we have seen, account number, we say mandatory no. That means it's not a mandatory field. Request reason is, we say this is yes. That means to submit the access request, this field is a mandatory field. Next column is editable. Here also, if we say yes or no, if we say editable, then this specific field is an editable field. Next column is visible. Here you can select when the access request, this particular column should be visible or not. We can say yes or no. If let's say there is a mandatory field and it's a editable, then this visibility also should be yes. So the next column is visible. Here we can specify this particular field should be visible in the access request. So we can select yes or no. If you say yes, then this will be visible. Let's assume that particular field should not be visible and it's not a mandatory field, then we can specify this as no. So let's check in our system. Here, let's go to SPRO and go to governance, risk and compliance, access control, user provisioning, end user personalization. Click here, then we'll come to the screen. Here you can see 999. This is the end user personalization setting which is delivered by SAP using BC sets. We select this and see what is inside. So this is the description. It's a default value. Here we can say whether this is mandatory or not. Here we can say whether it's editable. Then we can specify whether this is visible or not. For testing purpose, we just maintain this default value is 1234 in the account number, so that we can see whether this is working correctly or not. So you can make all the necessary changes, then save these changes. And you can have any number of UUP ID. Simply create a new one, then put an 3-digit number, then a name and a description. Then we can configure it. Let's say 100 test GRC training demo. Then select this and go to maintain, and we can start maintaining this. We don't want to save this, so it's fine. Let's go to the next slide. Next one, we are discussing about configuration setting, which is related to access request management. We have a couple of configuration settings. First one is risk analysis, access request parameter group 9. This is risk analysis during access request. So we have two here, 1071, that is enabled risk analysis on form submission. That means while submitting the request, would you like to do a risk analysis by default? So if we can say yes, then it will do the risk analysis. 1072, mitigation of critical risk required before approving the request. That means before approving the request, so you are forced to assign some mitigation control. So we have a couple of configuration like this. Next one is access request role selection. So we have a couple of role selections we can change. Next one is access request default role. This configuration related to the default roles. Next one is access request role mapping. We have two different parameters for role mapping as well. Let's see in our system. So go to SPRO, governance, risk and compliance, go to access control, maintain, configuration setting. Here we have couple of requests we already configured. 1071, enable risk analysis while submission, we said no. Mitigation critical request and approval, we said no. Access request role selection, allow all role for approvers. So if you don't know, we can simply select new and select this specific parameter group, then it will display all the parameter group which are related to the specific group which I have shown you before. Let's say access request, select this, say click, and it will show you what all the parameters available under this group. So once you select this one, then parameters value you simply select, and it will give you the options which is available. Yes. We have a couple of more provisioning settings in our SPRO which is related to user access management. Let's see it here. Define number range for provisioning request. This is a mandatory requirement. So we need to define a number range for user provisioning. So whenever we create a request in our GRC system, the request will carry a number. So we need to define this number range. Second one is maintaining setting for HR trigger. So we need to maintain the trigger ID, which we have also seen in the previous session, the use of HR trigger. We can maintain in this SPRO setting. Maintain SLA, service level agreement, and define request type. We can create different request type. Let's say this new request, or change role, or change user account, or delete user account, unlock users, like this. Next one is maintain priority configuration. You can also have different priority configuration, then you can classify the request based on the priorities. Define employee type, the HR employee type, we can also define it here. and maintain user default. This is for the user master defaults, and maintain password self-service. If you use password self-service in your GRC system, then you can maintain it here. Then maintain CUA settings. So let's see in our SAP system. Go to SPRO, SAP IMG, governance, risk and compliance, access control, user provisioning. Here we can first on maintain HR setting. We can maintain it here. You can maintain the action ID, then you can maintain the system for this specific action ID. Then maintain service level agreement. It's also same SLA ID. You will define this SLA ID, then we will define the MSMP process IDs here, then you can accordingly you can interlink your SLA with your MSMP process IDs. Then define request type. These are all the pre-delivered request type from SAP using busy sets. We can also create additional request type if it is necessary, or if you need to modify this, also possible. Define priority configuration. This also delivered by SAP. This is a standard priority coming from SAP. We can create it or modify it if it is necessary. Define employee types. Here we can define the employee type and the description. Here number range, defining number range. Here we can define the number range. We can create a new entry if it is necessary, otherwise you can just simply change the existing one. Once we create it, then we need to assign the number range to the object. So this number range 01 is assigned to the object GRAC request number. Then this is the starting number, this will be the ending number, and this is the current number. So you can create multiple number range for the same thing, and you can activate one of the number range which should be followed in that particular point in time. Next one is end user personalization, which we have seen. Maintain provisioning setting, which we have seen. This is maintain user defaults. Here you can specify user defaults. Here you can specify rejection reason, then password self-service, and maintain CUA settings. In maintain CUA setting, we can define the global system as well as the distributed system or the target system. So we can define the connectors, whether it's active or not. When it is active, then you select and define the target system and the CUA child systems. So let's create a template. So in our end user personalization, we have UUP ID 999. We have these datas there. So let's go to NWBC. In NWBC, go to Access Management. Then you will go to Access Request Administration. Here, Template Management. Here you simply say Create. Let's give a name for our template. G_TMPL_REQ01. And this is the role which we will be using, TM placed request. Okay, G_T emp underscore req 01. grc demo template during training. Here we can select the EUP ID. Anyway, we have only one ID. If you have multiple ID, you can select. Here we can select the request type. So the template what we are creating for new request. Here we can specify access details. The access details, here we say add. First one, what we will do is we will add the system. We have only one system. Okay. Then go to add again. Then we need to select the roles. And I would like to mention it here, the access request management as well as the business role management work together hand in hand. That means these two modules share the same repository for roles as well as the role assignment to the users. So this works together. So if you need any roles which needs to be provisioned using access request management, then this needs to be defined in your business role management. So we will see that later, how do we do that. For this demo purpose, I already created a couple of roles. Let's select one of the role from here. I say single role, we can select the role type. Yeah, so I say single role, g underscore. The role which we want to create is critical user maintenance, the one which we used. Okay, let's select this role as our template role for our template. Okay, so we selected system as well as the role. So once I selected the system and role, we can also put some description and priority and user details, parameters, whatever it is required. Let's say add a parameter. Okay, and just simply say. Okay, so we have created a template on name g underscore tmp underscore req 01. With this, we are coming to the end of the session. Thank you very much for listening. I will see you in the next session. Bye-bye.